So good morning. Welcome back, or welcome to Yoga with Kira. So you're going to need an elastic band. I have one of those things you put on your leg, I think, or your arm for when you're out cycling. You could also use elastic bands or the elastic at the top of a sock. Okay, there, the elastic at the top of a sock. Okay, so if you don't have it right now, it's okay. So you can do the exercises without it, but later on today, find something that you can do this with, okay? So we're gonna start with our hands. So great, hold on a second. So, So put the elastic between your thumbs, see that there, between your thumbs, and you're gonna place them down on the ground or on a surface, ground, because it's there, okay? And now lift all your fingers off the ground, place them down, and then lift your thumbs off the ground. And so I'm fingers, thumbs, and just feel that. How easy or hard is it to keep your palms on the ground and lift all your fingers off, and then lift your thumbs off, fingers, thumbs, and then lift one thumb, the other thumb. And so you're now just moving one thumb up and down. And then just one finger, set of fingers up and down. And then opposite fingers and thumbs. Yeah. God, I have to think for this one. I can't focus on ye. Great, that's working. My mouth wants to do something though, to help. So can you lift your thumb and your fingers of, so it's the opposite thumb and fingers that are lifting, opposite thumb and fingers that are lifting. Is that easy or hard for you? So we're gonna do the same thing with our feet now, okay? So, let me get rid of that. So standing up, and thanks Nella. Oh, maybe it was Bernadette. Anyways, I think it was Nella who said, who reminded me of this. So now put the elastic across the two of your big toes, okay? And walk your feet wide enough apart that you can feel that your toes are being pulled towards each other. So there's quite a space now between my big toe and my next toe, okay? And just feel that. So lift up and down on your heels a few times. So this is the anti-bunion exercises stuff. So the main thing is that often when we're walking in shoes, our organization of our muscles all start to be that our toes are in, and then we get used to that. So now we're just trying to strengthen our muscles with our toes pointing straight forward. I just feel that. Lift your heels up. You can have a stick if you want to, or a wall. You just, toes are being stretched and you're just lifting your heels up and down. Okay. So now the tricky part, I'm gonna lean forward to look. So lift only your big toes off the floor. And then lift all your other toes off the floor, keeping your big toes down. So big toes, all your toes, big toes, small toes, big toes, small toes. And just feel that. I actually wanna stand up tall. It feels more connected. And then just one toe, one big toe, one big toe. And then we're gonna try the opposites. I have no idea how this is gonna work, okay? So the big toe of one foot and the small toes of the other. Oh, a bit of organization kind of works. No, I'm totally confused. So just try, just kind of go big toe this side, small toes. Big toe this side, small toes, right? And then just wiggle your toes in general. Just let all your toes lift off the floor and wiggle, okay? Nice. And then roll your knees in a circle with your toes being stretched like this. And then roll your knees in the other direction with your toes being stretched like this. And even close your eyes and feel what is different about this than usual. Straighten your legs, come up onto your toes. What's different? Because there's a different action in the toes than what we're usually doing if your toes are being stretched like this. So now the tricky part, take your elastic off and now keep the space with the effort of your own feet. Okay, so now I'm making a space between my big toe and my next toe, and I'm gonna lift my heels off the floor. So now I'm making the space with muscular effort, and I have to kind of redo it every single time almost, because the tendency is that my toe will just go in. Nice. And then from here, lift your big toes off the floor. Lift your baby toes up, small toes, big toes, small toes, big toes, small toes. Nice. So we're going to now use this in our movement. So come stand to the front of your mat. You can't really see my head at the moment, but that's okay. So standing at the front of your mat and just feel your feet on the floor and make the big toe space between your, so the big toe space, we're going to call it, make the big toe space. Okay. Reach your arms wide, bring your palms together, keeping the big toe space, bending your elbows, bending your knees. Check out, do you still have big toe space? Hands to your shins, lift your chest and look forward. Hands to the floor, keep the big toe space and stretch back with your leg and drop down. And just see, how would you really commit to creating space in your toes as you move? Drop your right knee down. Bring your left hand to your left knee and reach the right hand up towards the ceiling, reaching up, looking up. Really feel that somehow you're still maintaining that big toe space. Really get a sensory or a somatic sense of it. Nice. Hands to the floor, both hands to the floor. Step back into your plank. Wiggle your toes around so that you feel I'm creating big toe space. Knees to the floor, belly to the floor. Stretch all your toes really wide. And then bring your hands to the floor, lift your feet off the floor and rise and look forward way down the beach. Stretch all your toes really wide. So I have big toe space, but I have whole toe space. All my toes are reaching. Nice. Pushing back into a cat. When you place your feet down, have them really wide and spread. Sit your bum back. Begin to rock forward and backwards, but maintain that sense of big toe space. How do you connect into your feet as you move? So I even do this thing where I anchor my big toe down and then I stretch all my other toes away from it. So I actually feel this kind of stretching of the big toe as I rock forward and backwards. Nice. Push back into your downward dog. Create big toe space. So now you can see your feet. What are they doing back there? So this is really beautiful thing. So when you lift your toes off the floor and place them back down, you'll see these lines traveling down towards your feet. See those? There's the muscles and the ligaments at the front of your feet. They'll be like little strings. So just see, what direction do the strings come down, and do your toes continue the line, or do your toes travel in a different direction than the strings? Typically, the smaller toes travel more or less. The baby toe doesn't usually travel in the same direction because it's been squished in, and the big toe usually doesn't travel because it's been squished in as well. The middle ones usually are in line. Notice for you. So interesting. Nice. Drop your knees to the floor. Sit your bum back into a child's pose and just let your feet rest. Let them soften. Feel the ease or the squish. Moment of pause. Really let them relax. Somebody messaged me last night to say that they did a pedicure. And they're so appreciating their feet. People are messaging me all the time, actually. The feet are doing something to you guys. I know, one of my feet, I keep thinking that I'm standing on water. People are like, oh, did I stand on a puddle? Usually, typically, puppy pee in this house. But I was going, oh, did I stand on a puddle? And it's just that my foot is feeling the ground differently. It's amazing. I'm really intrigued. Nice. Push back into your downward dog. And then you're going to step the right foot forward. So how would you do that? Drop your knees down, step your right foot forward, lengthen your back leg. So turn your back foot at a 45 degree angle and check out that you can bend your knee. So if your foot's at the wrong angle, you can't bend your knee. So you should be able to bend your knee and then straighten your back leg and push, squeeze the buttock on the left side. So your left leg is now super active. Find the baby toe side of your foot and now create the big toe space. Big toe space on the front foot, right elbow to your right knee, left hand to your hip. So we're just focusing on the lower body. So push, squeeze with the left hip. Left leg is super strong. Baby toe side of your foot is anchored. There's a big toe space at the front. Very strong. So on the front leg, I'm squeezing it slightly and then expanding into the buttock behind me. So many different things. Just keep that sense of connection. How do I connect into these legs in this moment? So again, bend your left knee and then straighten, push, squeeze, baby toe side, big toe space. Create length through your spine now. Let your spine grow out of that base that you've created. So nice. Both hands to the floor. Hop your back foot forward. And slowly rolling up. Keep your big toe space. Rolling up all the way up. Palms together. Palms come to rest in front of your chest. Nice. Shake out one leg. It's so bright outside. I can see all my daffodils. So beautiful. Nice. Other side. So, creating your big toe space, reach your arms wide, palms come together, reaching up, looking up. Bending your elbows, bending your knees, keep your big toe space as you lower down. Hands to your shins, lift your chest, look forward. Nice. Hands to the floor. Both feet are creating big toe space as you stretch your left foot back. It's into the point, so the ball of my foot is reaching back. My toes are spreading, and then I lower down. Drop your knee to the floor. Keep connected into your feet, right hand to your knee. Reach your left hand up. So really widening, reaching into your toes, creating that space. Super, hands to the floor, step back. Big toe space, really stretching your toes wide in your plank. Keep that space, lower all the way down. Stretch into your feet, rising up, look forward. How do you stretch a little bit more into your soles of your feet, into the balls of your feet, into the length of your feet? Nice. Pushing back into your cat. And then rocking forward. Keep the sense of connection into your feet as you move forward and backwards. Big toe space is happening. Again, I keep anchoring my big toe down and then moving my toes away from them. So it's like I'm kind of cheating a little bit. Is that cheating, I wonder? If I'm using the pressure of the floor to create space. Rocking forward, rocking backwards. Nice, push back into your downward dog. Check out the lines. So if you wiggle your toes or lift your heels up and down, you'll see the lines through the front of your feet. Let them move. Can you feel the front of your feet? Creating big toe space. Baby toe space, much harder again. Oh, wow. That's for another day. Knees to the floor. Step your left foot forward. Nice. Lengthen your back leg. Turn the back foot at a 45 degree angle. Bend your back knee. So if your foot's at the wrong angle, you won't be able to bend your knee. So great, bend your knee. Anchor down into the, so bend your knee and then push, squeeze into the right hip. The thong should engage. Connect into the baby toe side. Feel the big toe space. Left elbow, left knee. Front foot is really engaging into the big toe space. Nice. Turn your chest towards the right. So if you want, you can bend your knee slightly and push, squeeze into that right hip. Lengthening deeply into that leg. Baby toe side is connected. Big toe side is stretching. Really feel it, sense it. How do you move your feet? Connect into your feet. So do it again, soften everything, and then cha-chung, connecting, and then create length through your spine. From that base, push, squeeze in the hip, baby toe, big toe, lengthen. Nice, both hands to the floor, step forward or hop forward. Slowly rolling up, reach your arms wide, palms come together, palms come to rest in front of your chest. Nice, so we're gonna do a standing swan. So feet are hip distance apart, create the big toe space. Look at that, you can see the light through the, I'm gonna change all the things soon so that we can see more sky. I'm missing sky. So feet, and then bend your knees, squeeze deeply into the front of your hips, okay? And then push, squeeze into your hips, okay? Bend your knees, fold deeply into the front. So I really feel this sense of my belly and my thighs are squishing towards each other. My buttocks are opening as a result. Push, squeeze, hips are opening. Bum is squeezing, folding, and so there's a squeeze on both sides. One is a folding squeeze, and then this one is a pushing squeeze. Folding squeeze, pushing squeeze. So this movement we can do with the swan. So reach your arms up and lean backwards and push, squeeze your hips, and then fold, squeeze as you dive forward. Push, squeeze. Legs are strong, big toe space. Fold, squeeze. So swan going backwards, legs are connected. Swan going forward, legs are connected. How do you move in deep connection? How low can you go? How deep down towards the floor can you travel? In wellness, always. How deeply can you travel backwards? Push, squeeze. Push, squeeze. One more time each way. So awesome. Whoa. So cool. Come lie on your floor. And stretch your legs up and shake your legs. So as you shake your legs, can you feel the shaking in your big toes? Can you feel that all your toes are kind of rocking or wobbling a little bit up there? Can you feel the spaces between your toes? Nice, roll your ankles in big circles. And then roll in the other direction. Nice, feet to the floor, arms are wide, rock from side to side. Rocking, rocking. Nice, pause and just check in with your body. One last movement before the end of the class, but let it arise from you. I'm going to do gliders just because I love gliders. See what your body calls for. What would answer the call of this moment in your body? It's very interesting always. You know, that's how we create a practice in our own time, is that we It's a call and respond rather than something that we just repeat over and over again. That also has merit. But when we call and respond, we're listening to the sensations, we're perceiving sensations and tones and textures. And then we begin to wonder what would meet that or respond to that. It's very nice. Super. So come lie on the floor and either have your legs straight or the soles of your feet together and just pause. Put the soles of your feet together and just let your toes connect to each other. Let them wiggle and just say hello. Hi. Hello. So cute. Toes are very adorable when they meet. They're like, hi. Hi, I haven't seen you in ages. Oh. Nice. And then just settle. Let that rest within you. Nice. Stay there. Don't go anywhere. Just pausing. Wow, it was really nice. So maybe get, you know, those, you can get these bands that you put on your wrist, like Life Form, or like Josef has one, Inner Fire from Wim Hof. And they're really amazing. They're like a slightly thicker band that would fit around your wrist. They're the perfect things for your toes. I don't know where, I think Tiger have them. I think shops have, I think maybe the local petrol station has them. So great. Thanks for joining me. And yeah, keep noticing your toes. I know I'm kind of obsessed at the moment. Very enjoyably obsessed with my feet. See you tomorrow. Another bright and wonderful day, I'm sure. So great. Nice. Ciao, ciao. Be well. Be you. Be awesome. And thanks for joining me. Bye.